My name's Julie, and I'm a knitter and crocheter and a craft blogger over at Julie Measures, and I'm so excited to be here with you guys today. We're going to do some crocheting today. So if you've never been here for one of our Fiber Friday videos before, I kind of alternate back between knit videos and crochet videos, and we go step by step through the patterns. This week is a crochet video. So 2 weeks ago, when we did our last crochet video, we made these cute kind of applique bunnies, crochet bunnies, for Easter. So I've been doing lots of spring crafting, lots of spring knitting and crocheting, and we're going to keep working on that today. So, like I said, 2 weeks ago, we made this cute little guy. And today we're going to crochet a little egg that kind of matches and goes with him. So if you go to my website, which is juliemeasures.com, you can grab these free crochet patterns. So, this is what we're doing today, is this crochet egg pattern. Hi Brittany, welcome. And then you can also find the crochet bunny pattern. In the video description, I put a link to a craft I did, a DIY Easter tree, and within that blog post, it has links to both the bunny crochet pattern and to the egg crochet pattern that we're going to do today. So, kind of as a demonstration, this is my craft table that's full of stuff. So, this is an Easter tree that I've been working on for this year. Hi, Emily. So right now it just has these egg kind of terrariums that I made. So this one has like a little bunny in it. Some of them have little eggs. So thanks, Erin. So I'm going to add my crochet stuff that I'm making kind of to this tree that I have in progress. So that's what we're going to do there. Last week, if you missed it, I'm going to reach across my table. For knitting last week, we did these this knit hat, and I demonstrated how to do cables, if you've never done cables before. And then I also showed how to do the little baubles that I use for his little paws and the little tail. So if you want to check out the video from last week, you can look at that knit one. And then today we're doing the crochet. So that's our little bunny from last week. And then today we're going to do this crochet Easter egg. So I have just some medium weight yarn. I got this blue. I really like the way blue eggs look for spring, for Easter. I think they're really cute. I'm kind of on a blue bonnet kick right now. We've got blue bonnets. I'm here in North Texas near Dallas, and there's blue bonnets everywhere. So I just kind of have that on the brain. So I just grabbed some blue yarn to work on today to do this project. And that's a worsted weight, which is like a medium or an Aran weight, depending on where you live. It might be called different things, like a size 4, but it's just kind of a standard craft store yarn. I also have a size H, which is a 5mm crochet hook. So that's really all you need. Once you have those two things, you can go grab the pattern from my website and start working on it. So I'm going to flip the camera around, and we're just going to go step by step. This is a really easy pattern. There's only 3 rounds, so we'll do the whole pattern together, and then if you have any questions, just let me know. This uses a treble crochet, a double crochet, half double crochet, and single crochet. So we'll go step by step through those stitches. I am using US crochet terms. So if you're in the UK or somewhere else, you might use slightly different terms than what I'm doing. I'm just kind of know that while you're following along. So talk amongst yourselves. I'm going to flip the camera around. Give me 1 second. You get a shot of my ceiling here in my office. And on the desk here, you can see all the supplies. So there's the pattern that you can grab. And try to make this so you're not seeing the legs of the tripod. Well, I've got it switched around. Okay, so there you go. And grab your yarn and crochet hook so we can get started. So here's the yarn, here's the crochet hook. Also gonna grab some scissors. Here's our little finished bunnies. You can look at him too. All right, so the pattern starts with a magic loop, and you could also, if you don't want to do the magic loop, you could just start with a slip knot. So, but I'm going to do the loop to start with. So, insert here. Okay, so if you missed that for the magic loop, I'm twisting this. That short piece is on top. The long piece is what is still connected over here to the yarn. It's the working yarn. And then this is the tail, the short end. So I've got the crochet hook. I'm going to grab that and pull it through and kind of turn that over. And that starts our magic loop. And then we can start following the pattern for our crochet egg. So the first thing is to chain one. So to chain, we're yarning over and pulling through. And then we're going to single crochet 10 inside the magic loop. So to single crochet, we go in the magic loop, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through the loops. There's 1, 2, 3, 4. And if you've never crocheted before, you can go find my YouTube channel, and I go over each one of these stitches individually and very slowly. I have projects that just focus on chain stitch, just focus on single crochet. Let's see how many I've done so far. So we can count how many single crochets we have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'll do 2 more. 9 and 10. Okay. And then the great thing about the magic loop or magic ring is that then I can pull it and it tightens down and just gives you a really nice center to start with. Okay. Then I'm going to slip stitch 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 back to my first single crochet to join that together. So then I've got a nice loop, I've pulled it tight in the back, and it's ready to go. Okay, so that's round one. Round two, I need to chain two, 1, 2, and then I'm gonna make a half double crochet. And to do that, we yarn over, and we go into the stitch, pull it through, and then yarn over and pull through all 3 stitches. Okay, then I'm going to chain 1. And then in the next spot, I am going to make 2 half double crochets. So there's 1 and 2, and then I'm going to chain 1, and then I'm going to repeat that. I'm going to make 2 half double crochets in each spot around. So obviously to make this kind of the circle as we start the egg, we're increasing
at each step around. One, two, and in that first spot, when we chained two, that counted essentially as one of the half double crochets in that spot. So then in each additional space around single crochet space, we're making two half double crochets and then chaining one. So we're ready to go to the next spot here, half double crochet. Half double crochet, chain one. Next spot, half double crochet, half double crochet, and then chain one. So we had 10 single crochets in the first round, so we'll have 20 half double crochets in this round, and then there should be 9 of the chain one spaces between those half double crochets. So we just keep working around for our egg. So we can count and see how many chain spaces we have. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. Then I'm chaining one here. There's 9. And then I'm going into that last single crochet space and making my 2 half double crochets. And actually, I think I am doing the wrong spot there. So actually we're stopping here because there's that chain space and I need to join it right here to that chain two spot. Okay, there we go. So I've got my 9 chain spaces and that is round 2. Okay, now for round 3, I want to slip stitch until I get to this chain space. So we slipped to join, and now I'm going to slip in that first half double we made, and now I've moved over to this chain one space. In the chain one space, I want to chain two, and then make 2 half double crochets in this space. So all in that one spot, I chained 2 and I made 2 half double crochets. Now I'm going to chain 1 and I'm going to go to the next chain 1 space from the previous round and make 3 half double crochets. There's 1, there's 2, and there's 3. Okay, then I'm going to make 3 double crochets in the next 2 spaces. So, yarn over, insert, pull through, and there's a double. And there's a double. And I'm doing it in the next 2 spaces. And basically what we're doing now is we want to make this egg shaped. It needs to be shorter on one side and then taller and then get shorter again. So we did some half doubles. Now we're doing double crochets because those are taller. Then in the next space, we're going to make 3 double crochets and not 2. The great thing about crocheting is you can just pull it out. Okay, 1, 2, 3. There we go. Now make 3 in this spot. 1, 2, and 3. Okay. Now we're going to make 3 treble crochets in this space. So to make the treble crochet, I'm yarning over twice, inserting the hook, pulling it through, pulling through once, twice, 3 times. So this will be the tallest point on our egg. So I'm making 3 treble crochets. Again, I'm using US terms for the crochet, if you missed any of the beginning. Okay, now I'm going to get smaller again. So we worked up half double, double, now this treble. And now the next couple spots, I'm going to go back to making my double crochets again. So 1, 2, 3 double crochets. I'm going to do that in 2 spots in a row. 1, 2, and 3. And in these final spots, I'm going to go back to making the half double crochet. 1, 2, 3, and then in the last spot, another 3 half doubles. 1, 2, and 3. And then you can see it made this pointy part on top. Okay, then I can slip these together. Slipped this in together and cut it off. And we have an egg. Cute little blue egg to hang on our Easter tree. So you can see kind of how we got that egg shape by increasing the height on those stitches as we went around. Okay, I'm going to make another one of these while we're here together. And then I'm going to show you how, if you want to make a garland out of the eggs and bunnies, you can string them all together for a fun Easter decoration. So I'm using the magic loop or magic ring to start the crochet. Chain 1. Now I need to make 10 single crochets inside of the loop. 3, 4, 5, 6, pull out some yarn, 7, and I'm kind of holding the end here, I don't want it to come out. Where am I? 8, 9, and 10. And then I can pull this to tighten it, and I can slip into that first single crochet I made, and that is our round 1. Then I stay with that single crochet where I slipped, and I'm going to chain 2, and this counts as our first half double crochet, and then I'm going to half double crochet in that same spot. And this is the beginning of round 2. Then I chain 1, and then I make 2 half double crochets in each stitch around. Each of my single crochets from round 1 now get 2 half double crochets. So half double, half double, these are all US terminology. If you missed any of the beginning, I'm making some cute little Easter egg decorations. And this is a medium weight yarn. And I'm using a size H or 5 millimeter crochet hook. And these will be really cute on the Easter tree that I made this year. I tend to remake these Easter trees every year. You can go check out the DIY over on my blog, on my website. they're really fun and easy to make, and it's something that the kids
can help me with
as well. Okay, so sometimes as you're working around, that magic ring will get loose, and you can just pull it tight again. And now I can't remember if I did a chain. I did. Okay. But I pulled it out. So now we'll chain again. Alright. I'm continuing my pattern of 2 half double crochets followed by a chain stitch in each of my single crochets from the previous round. This is a free pattern you can grab on my website. I know not everybody likes to read patterns. So this way you have the video and then you have the pattern too, and you can use both together. So we need to have, we had 10 single crochets in round 1. In round 2, we're going to end with 20 half double crochets and 9 of the chain 1 that are in between. So let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then this spot right here, 9. So let's join the end of round 2. And so far we still just have a circle shape. It's really in round 3 where we pull the look of the egg together. And I need to slip over to this chain spot. So I've slipped in this stitch, which is where we joined. I'm also going to slip in this next stitch and then into the chain. Now I'm going to chain 2 and then I'm going to make 2 half double crochets. That chain 2 really counts as my first half double crochet. So essentially I have 3 half double crochets in that chain 1 space. Then I can chain 1. And then I can go over here and make 3 more half double crochets. 1, 2, 3. And now I need to start getting taller to create that egg shape. So in the next spot, I'm making double crochets instead of just the half doubles. So I'm going to do 2. I did 2 spots of half double crochets. Now I'm going to do 2 of these chain 1 spaces that are double crochets. And I'm putting 3 double crochets in there. And then the next space, I'm going to do a treble crochet. And this is the peak of our egg. 1, 2, 3. And 1, 2, 3. Okay, then I can start decreasing my height again. I'm going to go back to the double crochet size, or stitch, height, however we want to say that. Got off there for a second. 1, 2, 3, and then the next group also gets the double crochet height. 1, 2, 3, and then our last 2 spots get the half double. So it works out that we have kind of a group of four half double crochets along the bottom because we start and end with the half double crochet size. And then we can just slip into that first space again and trim this. And knot that. And then you could use a tapestry needle or a smaller crochet hook or you could use the same size crochet hook. So I'd pull that back piece tight and then just kind of tuck in the ends. I might knot this one just so that center stays tight. But then you can just tuck in the ends of your egg on the center part, and then where we finished it off. And then once those are tucked in, we can trim them too. This little crochet hook is catching the yarn and not really pulling it through the way I want it to. So sometimes using a smaller crochet hook is nice because it fits in if your stitches are a little tight. These I kept pretty loose, so okay. So once you kind of tuck in the stitches, then you can just cut off the extra length, and this is the back side of that little blue egg. Okay, so say you've made a bunch of these and you want to string them all together, make an Easter garland out of them. You can grab any yarn that you want. Actually looking, I've got several yarns sitting here on my workspace area, but I think this other yarn that I grabbed is the same color. It is. It's that linen that I used for my bunny. So I really want a third color. That's gonna be, here we go. Dig another one out. I really wanted a third color that could be for kind of the garland. So, I just trimmed up this other one. This bunny's already been, all his ends have been tucked in. So, let's move these over. If you wanted, you could have a string just of the eggs. You could have a string just of the bunnies. You could do, I think it's fun to alternate. So I might do, you know, bunny, egg, bunny, egg, bunny, egg across. But you can just use a chain stitch. So we want to start with a slip knot. And then I can just do a chain stitch. So chain is yarn over, pull through loop. Yarn over, pull through loop. I can just make a chain stitch. And then I can just add on these pieces as I go. Now you could, okay, let's angle this camera up for just a second. I think there's my little Easter tree in progress. So I could just hang, you know, I could just make a loop or make a little hanger out of the yarn and hang that on the tree like that. But I could also put this back down for a second. I could also slip this onto the pieces that I've made. So I'm just doing kind of those three stitches at the top. And I just do that. I just use a slip stitch to attach that decoration to the chain I'm working on. And then it just hangs. So for the bunny, I might attach it at his ears. And you can kind of space this out however you want, but, you know, I might use just a slip stitch there. Then I need some chain stitches in the middle. A few more. I don't want it to pull his ears too far together. I kind of like the look of him. Okay, so then I can just slip that and add him on to my chain stitch. And this just makes a, you know, you can make a garland, a little bunting. You could wrap it around your Easter tree, which is what I did. If you follow the link in the video description, that's what I've done before. But you could hang this. I don't have a fireplace at my house, but if you did, you could hang it, you know, along the mantle. Anywhere that you need a little spring decoration. I kept these. I'm sorry, I pulled that way over. I went with kind of a neutral look for my pieces here, but you could do bright pastel eggs, you know, a bright pastel candy bunny. That's the wonderful thing about yarn, is that it's completely personalized. You can personalize it to you. I don't know what word I was looking for, but make it fit your personality, make it fit the colors that you're decorating with. It's one of my favorite things about making custom hats and things, is that I can just, you know, if I'm making gifts or orders for customers, I can, you know, work with you to make it look the way that you want it to. Okay. So that just makes a fun little Easter thing. If you live, I'm in Texas near Dallas. It is not cold. It's like 80 degrees today. If you live where it is still cold at Easter, don't forget, I do have this really cute knit bunny hat. The eggs and this bunny are free patterns. Just visit my website and you'll flip the camera back around. And get this all situated. Oh, I left the bright light on. Here, I'll get you nice and close so maybe I don't look so washed out. Okay. So you can go grab any of these patterns and get stitching for Easter. If you have any questions about knit stitches or crochet stitches, make sure to visit my Facebook page, Julie Measures. Give it a like. Let me know what your questions are. If you have a pattern that you'd like me to demo for you here, let me know. If there's a technique that you want help with that you want to see me do, I'm happy to put that on our schedule here. Next week, we'll be back to another knit video. Actually, I don't know if I'll be on next week because it's Easter. So we'll see. The kids, are out of school. So, but next time, the next time I'm here on Friday, will be a knit video. How's that? And we'll keep working on our knitting and crochet stitches and having fun with all of our fiber. So thanks for crafting with me today. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up if you are enjoying all of our fiber crafting. And again, let me know if you have any questions. And I can't wait to craft with you guys again soon. Bye.